Hello everyone, welcome to Semiconductor Fundamentals. In this session, I will be discussing on the common collector configuration of the NPN transistor. Let us start with the circuit diagram. We have two supply signals here, one across the base, another one across the emitter. Please note the collector in fact is the common terminal here. The output will always be taken from the load resistance which is R2 and the R1 will be called as the input resistance. In the common collector or grounded collector configuration, the collector is connected to the ground through the supply, thus the collector terminal is common to both the input and the output. The input signal is connected directly to the base terminal, while the output signal is taken from across the emitter load resistance as shown in the diagram. This type of configuration is commonly known also as voltage follower or emitter follower circuit. The common collector or emitter follower configuration is very useful for impedance matching applications because of its very high input impedance in the region of hundreds of thousands of ohms while having a relatively low output impedance. In the common collector configuration, the load resistance is connected in series with the emitter terminal, so the load current is equal to that of the emitter current. Since the base and collector currents flow into the transistor, we call them by convention as positive currents. On the other hand, since the emitter current flows out of the transistor, it will be regarded as negative current. As the emitter current is the sum of the collector and base currents, the load resistance in this type of transistor configuration also has both the collector current and the input current of the base flowing through it. Then the current gain of the circuit is given as, we start with the equation for the currents at first, IE is equal to IC plus IB. So the current gain is the ratio of IE to IB. Since IE is equal to IC plus IB as shown in the equation 1 here, and substituting the same and simplifying, we will get the current gain as beta plus 1. This type of bipolar transistor configuration is a non-inverting circuit in that the signal voltages Vin and Vout are in phase. Here VBB will be Vin and VEE will be Vout. As the transistor in the common collector configuration acts as a voltage follower, its voltage gain is unity. Thus, it can be considered as a voltage buffer. The load resistance of the common collector transistor receives both the base and collector currents, giving a large current gain, which is very similar to what a common emitter configuration does, therefore providing a good current amplification with very little voltage gain. Now we move on to the characteristics. We know that in order to forward bias a transistor, the base to emitter junction should be forward biased and the collector to base junction should be reverse biased. In this mode, the transistor will operate in active region. If both the base to emitter and the collector to base transistors are forward biased, then the transistor will enter the saturation region. In fact, we can write an equation that will dictate all these states as is shown here. Now, if the base to emitter voltage is less than the built-in turn-on voltage or the knee voltage, the transistor is in the cutoff region. If the base to emitter voltage is greater than the knee voltage and the base to emitter voltage is greater than the voltage across the collector to base terminals as well, then the device will be in the active region. And finally, if the base to emitter voltage is greater than the knee voltage but the base to emitter voltage is less than the collector to base voltage, then the device enters saturation. Now, we continue to the mathematical analysis of the circuit by applying the Kirchhoff's voltage law for both the input as well as the output loops. By applying KVL to the base collector loop, we get VBB plus VBC is equals to IBRB. Now, RB is nothing but R1 here. So, the current across the base can be given as VBB plus VBC divided by RB. We have given those equations here. Continuing in a very similar fashion and applying KVL to the emitter to collector loop, we get VEE minus of VEC is equal to IERE. Rearranging then, we will get IE is equals to VEE minus of VEC divided by RE. Re in fact is the load resistance and is denoted here as R2. Note that the voltage across the emitter to collector VEC is equal to voltage across the emitter to base plus the voltage across the base to collector circuit. Right? So with that, we now start with the input characteristics of the transistor. Input characteristics are obtained by plotting the voltage across the input terminals, which is VBC, and recording the input current IB at a fixed value of voltage across the output terminals VEC. Note that the negative terminal of the supply VBB is connected to the base terminal. As the input voltage VBB is increased, a negative voltage is applied across the base to collector terminals. This reverse biases the collector to base junction and hence the input current IB starts to decrease. If VBB is further increased, the current becomes lesser and lesser, and eventually, depending upon the values of other parameters in the circuit, this current will reach zero. This is indicated in the input characteristic curve diagram as we can see here. This, please note, is in contradiction to what happens in both the common base as well as the common emitter configurations, as the input current in those configurations increases with the increase in the voltage across the input terminals. Now, it should be noted that the base current is positive, however, the base to collector voltage is negative, and therefore, the input characteristics are obtained in the second quadrant. Here in the graph, you can note this is in fact the origin, and the negative x-axis indicates a negative voltage applied across the input terminals, and the positive y-axis indicates a positive current across the input terminal. Let us now move on to the output characteristics. Output characteristics are obtained by plotting the voltage across the output terminals VEC and recording the output current IE at a fixed value of input current IB. Note that the negative polarity of the supply VEE is connected to the emitter terminal. If the values of VBB and VEE are such that the potential difference between the base and emitter terminals are greater than the turn-on or the built-in voltage, also called as the knee voltage, the base to emitter terminal will be forward biased. Since the base to collector voltage is negative, the collector to base junction is always reverse biased. Therefore, the transistor in this configuration will never go into saturation region and will operate only in the active region. Therefore, when VEE is increased, the base to emitter voltage increases and hence the emitter current increases. If the output current IE is plotted versus the voltage across the emitter to collector terminals VEC at multiple values of input current IB, we obtain the output characteristic curves as we can see in the diagram here. Now, to understand this particular characteristic curve, let us put some values into those terminal voltages and see what happens into the current variation. For example, I'm going back to the circuit and assume that the voltage across the base to collector terminal is minus 3 volts. This means that a negative voltage is applied to the base terminal, which is made up of P region, and a positive voltage is applied to the collector, which is made up of N region. Therefore, as we already have discussed, the collector to base junction will be reverse biased. If we now continue to assume and say the voltage across the emitter to collector terminal is minus 4 volts, then we find that the potential difference between the base, which is at minus 3, and the collector, which is at minus 4, will give a resultant voltage of minus 3 minus of minus 4, which is equals to plus 1. And since this is greater than the knee voltage that is required, which is approximately 0.7, we say the base to emitter junction is forward biased. Therefore, the emitter current IE will have the same shape as what a diode current will have in the forward biasing condition. Since the emitter current IE is flowing out of the transistor and is therefore regarded as negative, also since the emitter to collector voltage is also negative, we obtain the output characteristics of this particular configuration in the third quadrant. This is shown in the diagram here. So if you look at the characteristic curves that we have obtained here, and assuming for some value of IB, we will obtain a characteristic curve that is very similar to what a diode forward characteristic curve would look like. If I simply repeat the experiment for different values of the input current, which is IB, then simply I will obtain further characteristic curves shifted only by a small voltage difference across the x-axis. Right, with that we now continue to the transfer characteristics of the configuration. Transfer characteristic is obtained by plotting the voltage across the input terminals VBC and recording either the output current IE or the voltage across the output terminals VEC. Figure here indicates the transfer characteristic curves of this particular configuration. Here we have two different plots. Both the x-axis are the same, which are the voltages across the input terminals. However, in the plot that is down, we have the y-axis as the output current and the upper plot as the y-axis, which is equal to the voltages across the output terminals. It should be noted that the response of this particular configuration is completely linear. This is because when the base emitter junction is forward biased and the collector to base junction is reverse biased, any increase in input voltage, which is VBB, will increase the voltage across the emitter terminal, and therefore the emitter to collector voltage also increases. Since the emitter to collector voltage increases, the output current IE also increases, and hence a linear graph. Well, that brings us to the end of this session. To summarize, we discussed the input, output and transfer characteristics of an NPN transistor in common collector configuration. If you like this video, press that like button and leave a comment. If you want to watch my future videos as well, you can always subscribe to my channel. Well, that's it from this session. Thank you for watching. Have a good day.